We are going to see about the second unit of our Manufacturing Technology 1 course, which has the subject code 19ME502. In the syllabus, we have the operating principle, basic equipment, merits and applications of the fusion welding processes, gas welding types, flame characteristics, manual metal arc welding, gas tungsten arc welding, gas metal arc welding, submerged arc welding, electro slag welding, operating principle and applications of resistant welding, plasma arc welding, thermite welding, electron beam welding, friction welding and friction stir welding, and brazing and soldering, and the welding defects, its types, causes and the cure. Generally, we classify the welding processes into two categories. One is a fusion welding, another one is a solid state welding. We can call it as a pressure welding. So, fusion welding, coalescence is accomplished by melting the two parts to be joined. In some cases, we use some filler metal for the joint to be made. Examples, arc welding, resistance spot welding, oxy fuel gas welding, etc. And in solid state welding, we apply heat or pressure to achieve this coalescence, but no melting of base metal occurs. And also here we do not require filler metal for the joint to be made. Examples of forge welding, diffusion welding, friction welding. Diagrammatically, we can use this flowchart to classify this welding. So, welding generally the solid state welding, what we call as pressure welding, and fusion welding. Under pressure welding, we have all these categories what we have in the syllabus, right? Series resistance, spot, seam projection, butt, flash, and also friction, ultrasonic, cold pressure welding, and also induction welding. So, the special types of weldings. Whereas in fusion welding, we will go for the traditional, the conventional methods using gas and also electrical arc. And in advanced technology, we use power beam like laser welding and electro beam welding. This arc welding can be again classified into metal arc welding or gas sealed arc welding. In the metal arc welding, we have manual metal arc welding or submerged metal arc welding. Whereas in gas sealed arc welding, we have gas metal arc welding, that is metal inert gas, using metal inert gas, that is what MIG, and gas tungsten arc welding. So we can use this, we can call it as gas tungsten arc welding, GTAW, and plasma welding. In fusion welding, we use a liquid metal welding, or you can use gas for the welding. Or we can use the resistance for the fusion of the metals to take place, which is called as the electro slag welding. Arc fusion welding, electron beam welding and laser welding. So, all these cases here the metal will melt and fuse to together so that they can be joined. So, here in arc fusion welding, we have metal arc welding that can be manual metal arc or gravity arc or fire. Firecrackers welding or flex code metal arc welding, and we have gas sealed tungsten arc welding. There we have tungsten inert gas, that is TIG welding, plasma arc welding or atomic hydrogen welding, and again this narrow gap welding, electro gas welding, plasma MIG welding, inert gas metal arc welding, active gas metal arc welding. Again it will be classified into carbon dioxide welding and gas mixture sealed welding. Thus, in pressure welding, we use forge welding, pressure gas welding, resistance welding, friction welding, diffusion welding, cold pressure welding, ultrasonic welding, arc pressure welding. Here, the metals do not melt, whereas it will be heated up to red hot gel like condition. Then it can be applied some pressure, and it can be joined together.